in the abdominal cavity. So in case of cryptorchidism, the testes remains same in the abdominal cavity. So we know that after pregnancy, after 7 months of pregnancy, after 7 months of pregnancy, if the fetus is male, then the testes descend into the scrotal sac. Again, try to understand this thing. As I said before, that after 7 months of pregnancy, if the fetus is male, then the testes that descend into the scrotal sac. But in case of cryptorchidism, the testes remain same in the abdominal cavity. As the testes remain same in the abdominal cavity, so there is no spermatogenesis process. Because in the abdominal cavity, the temperature is same as to body temperature. Listen again, what is cryptorchidism? In cryptorchidism disorder, testes remain same in the abdominal cavity. So as we know that after 7 months of pregnancy, if the fetus is male, then the testes descend into the scrotal sac. So that the spermatogenesis process takes place and the sperm produced at the time period. So if the cryptorchidism disorder takes place, then what happens? Testes remain same in the abdominal cavity. So there is the temperature that equal to the body temperature. That's why no spermatogenesis takes place in the disorder that is cryptorchidism. Then the next disorder. Inguinal hernia. So in inguinal hernia, the loop is created at the scrotal sac. So what do you mean by inguinal canal? Inguinal canal means the connection between the abdominal cavity and the scrotal sac is called as your inguinal canal. So inguinal hernia means, see the diagram, this is your scrotal sac. In case of male, inguinal canal is present in case of male. So this is the scrotal sac and this is your inguinal canal. This is your abdominal cavity. So inguinal canal means the canal that connect the scrotal sac to the abdominal cavity, that is inguinal canal. So what is the disorder? That is inguinal hernia. In case of inguinal hernia, loop is created at the scrotal sac. That means here is the a loop is created. So what happens if the loop is created at the scrotal sac? See, as we know that in the scrotal sac there is a presence of seminiferous tubule. So there is presence of seminiferous tubule. And what is the function of seminiferous tubule? The function of seminiferous tubule is the production of sperm. So, So, in the scrotal sac, there is a presence of seminiferous tubule. So, what is the function of seminiferous tubule? The function of seminiferous tubule is the production of sperm. So, the production of sperm means, as we know that, what is the function of vas efferentia? The function of vas efferentia is to carry the sperm. The function of vas deferentia is to carry the sperm. As we know that after the epididymis, the vas deferentia is present. So when the sperm is formed, it enter into the vas efferentia. It enter into the vas efferentia. Then because of the loop, the sperm that unable to cross the pathway. Because of the loop, the sperm that is unable to enter into the urogenital duct. Again, I repeated, what do you mean by inguinal hernia? Listen, understand carefully, what do you mean by inguinal hernia? Inguinal hernia means loop is created at the scrotal sac. Loop is created at the scrotal sac. That means, see, this is your scrotal sac. This is your scrotal sac. So, the loop is created at this part. The loop is created at this part. So, when the loop is created, as we know that the function of scrotal sac is it having the seminiferous tubule. It having the seminiferous tubule, and the function of seminiferous tubule is it produce the sperm. It produce the sperm. So when the loop is created, it acts as a barrier. It acts as a barrier for the movement of sperm into the urogenital duct. So, because of this loop, the sperm that is unable to move the urogenital duct. So, as it cannot able to reach the urogenital duct, so it cannot enter into the penis and the fertilization cannot take place. That disease is called as your inguinal hernia. That disease is called as your inguinal hernia. Then the next disease. Then the next disorder, that is gynecomastia. Gynecomastia means enlargement of breast in case of male. So gynecostomia, it is a disorder that is enlargement of breast in case of male. Gynecomastia, it is a disorder that is enlargement of breast in case of male. Then the next disorder, hysterectomy. Hysterectomy means the removal of uterus in case of female. Hysterectomy means removal of uterus in case of female. That disorder is called as your hysterectomy. The next disorder is ectopic pregnancy means the zygote. the zygote. The zygote unable to move in the fallopian tube, that is ectopic pregnancy. Listen again carefully. What do you mean by ectopic pregnancy? Ectopic pregnancy means zygote unable to move in the fallopian tube. Zygote unable to move in the fallopian tube. That means it's a type of disorder where the zygote unable to move in the fallopian tube, that is called as your ectopic pregnancy. Clear? So completed your reproductive disorder. Again, I said the reproductive disorder. First of all, oligospermia. Oligospermia means the sperm count is very less in this disorder. Then come to azoospermia. Azoospermia means absence of sperm in the fallopian tube. Then come to the disorder that is cryptokaridism. Cryptokaridism means testis remains in the abdominal cavity, that means it unable to descend in the scrotal sac. Then the next disorder, that is inguinal hernia. Inguinal hernia means the loop, a loop is created at the scrotal sac so that the sperm unable to move at the urinogenital duct. Then the next disorder, that is gynecomastia. Gynecomastia means enlargement of breast in case of male. As we know that the breast only enlarges in case of female, but when it enlarges in case of male, in the that disorder is called as your gynecomastia. Then come to the disorder that is hysterectomy. Hysterectomy means removal of uterus in case of female. As we know that the female having uterus, so uterus helps in the implantation process. So hysterectomy means the removal of uterus in case of female. That disorder is called as your hysterectomy disorder. Then next come to the disorder that is ectopic pregnancy. Listen about ectopic pregnancy. If ectopic pregnancy means the zygote unable to move in the fallopian tube. Zygote unable to move in the fallopian tube. Such type of disorder is called as your ectopic pregnancy. So completed your reproduction system, then come to the next chapter, that is reproductive health. Reproductive health. So as we know about the reproduction system, so we have must that knowledge about the reproductive health. So next, see, according to who the abbreviation of who is World Health Organization. So the abbreviation of who is World Health Organization. According to World Health Organization, the definition of reproductive health is a state of complete well-being of all aspect of So listen carefully, what is the definition of reproductive health in according to the definition of WHO? So WHO, the abbreviation of WHO is World Health Organization. So according to WHO, the definition of reproductive health is a state of complete well-being of all aspect of reproductive system. That means if the reproductive system is very healthy, then only we just try to gain the knowledge of reproductive system. Again, I repeated, what is the definition of reproductive health? Reproductive health, according to WHO, a state of complete well-being of all aspect of reproductive system. That means, amamanako case re, jodi reproductive health, reproductive system, that is, tomorrow reproductive system re jibo, टेस्टिस हो कि ओवरी हो कि मामरी ग्लैंड एवरीथिंग दैट इंक्लूड इन द रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम everything that included in the reproductive system that must be healthy seta kon raha darkar pele healthy rahiba darkar mu kon kahili in all aspect means in physical emotional and social again try to understand what is the definition of reproductive health according to who a state of complete well being of all aspect of reproductive system that means tamara physically ho ki emotionally ho ki socially ho tamara reproductive system ta sabale kon rohar achi healthy rohar achi that is your reproductive health so in 1951 So in 1951, certain country included our India, the reproductive health is termed as your family planning. Family planning. Then gradually, this family planning termed as reproduction system. And child care program. See, in 1951, again I repeated, in 1951, the reproductive health that is to include our in many countries. In many countries, the reproductive health that is termed as family planning. एंड आफ्टर फ्यू इयर्स लेटर किछि वर्ष परे रिप्रोडक्ट फैमिली प्लानिंग को पुनी कोन कहा गला रिप्रोडक्शन सिस्टम एंड चाइल्ड केयर प्रोग्राम रिप्रोडक्शन सिस्टम मीन्स यू नो अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ एंड चाइल्ड केयर प्रोग्राम मीन्स हाउ टू केयर द चाइल्ड सो द टू टर्म दैट इज यूज्ड इन इंडिया फॉर द रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ देन सी What are the problem that takes place in the reproductive health? The problems that related in the reproductive health. The first problem that related to the reproductive health is your lack of awareness. That means people, they don't know about the reproductive health. They don't know about the menstrual cycle. They don't know about the lactation. They don't know about how to prevent the pregnancy. So that is lack of awareness. Again, I repeated the problem that related to reproductive health is the first is lack of awareness. That means lack of knowledge. So in certain rural area, people don't know about how to avoid the pregnancy. How about the lactation, about the mammary gland, everything. So that is lack of awareness. Lack of awareness means a baby, ketra rural area re, loko mane jani nanti ki mammary gland bisare, tamar lactation bisare, how to avoid pregnancy, pregnancy kemti avoid koribo. That is lack of awareness. Then the second problem is population. So nowadays also the uneducated people, ebe bi jo mane patha padhi nanti, uneducated people, the population increase means loko mane kemiti badhu chanti. Jodi jone patha padhi nathibo, se kon karibo ta family planning jani nathibo, to se kon karibo gote papma ra at least 7 ta ki 8 ta chua thibe, hela? To taku kon kahibe? Population increase boli kahibe, thik achi? So population increase means in a single family, that means a single parents, they reproduce at least 7 children. 7 to not more than 2. That is nowadays after 1951, according to the Family Planning Act, What is population increase? Population increase means if a single parent they create or they reproduce more than two children, that is population increase. Then the next is abortion. Abortion means illegal pregnancy. Abortion means illegal pregnancy. Legal pregnancy means जोड़ा फैमिली रो अंडर रे होतिबो हला मैरिज पर जोड़ा ताको लीगल कहबे. इलीगल मींस बिफोर मैरिज द प्रेगनेंसी इज कॉल्ड योर इलीगल प्रेगनेंसी. ओके सो नाउअडेज व्हाट हैपेंड इफ द गर्ल दे प्रेग्नेंट बिफोर मैरिज सो दे विल गो टू द डॉक्टर एंड दे क्रिएट दे अंडर गो अबॉर्शन. से माने कोन करछन पिले जदि मैरिज पूर्व रु के प्रेग्नेंट भी होउछन तो से माने कोन करछन डॉक्टर को पाखु जे कोन करछन अबॉर्शन कर दोउछन. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज योर इलीगल अबॉर्शन. सो these are the three main problem in reproductive health. Again I repeated, the main problem in reproductive health is, first is lack of awareness. Lack of awareness means till now the people in rural area, they don't know about the reproductive system, about the lactation, about the mammary gland, all those things. That is lack of awareness, understand? Then see, population increase. So according to the family planning act, what happens is parent they only reproduce two child, clear? If they reproduce more than two child, that undergoes the population increase. Then next come to the problem, that is abortion. Abortion means if a girl is pregnant before marriage, then that abortion is called as your illegal abortion. Hello. Then come to the topic, that is strategy about the reproductive health. The strategy about reproductive health. So the first strategy about reproductive health is to create awareness. The first strategy about reproductive health is create awareness. Create awareness. So being educated, we have to create awareness among all the people. सो आम एजुकेटेड है कि आम काम कौन जिते भी लोक अच्छा कौन अवेयर कर रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ विषय अवेयर कर दे सुड हाव टू नो अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्टिव डिजर्डर दे सुड हाव टू नो अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. सो आज वी बींग एजुकेटेड एज वी आर एजुकेटेड स्टूडेंट सो वी हाव टू विल गो टू द रूरल एरिया एंड वी शुड गिव अवर बेस्ट नॉलेज टू दोज पीपल दे सुड नो अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. आम काम कौन आम समस्त को जो मैंने किसी जाणी ना विषय आमर जी नॉलेज अच्छी से कौन कर रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ विषय नॉलेज देवा है. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड इज योर व्हाट क्रिएट अवेयरनेस. सो आम विषय नॉलेज देवा फर्स्ट विल गिव देम द नॉलेज अबाउट एसटीडी. We will give the awareness about STD. STD means the abbreviation of STD is sexually transmitted disease. So the abbreviation of sexually transmitted disease. Try to understand what is sexually transmitted disease. Sexually transmitted disease means the disease that transmits through sex, that is called as your sexually transmitted disease. Again, I repeated the definition of STD. The definition of STD is, see here I write down, the definition of STD is So STD means what? Sexually transmitted disease. डिजीज द ट्रांसमिटेड थ्रू सेक्स इज कॉल्ड एज योर सेक्सुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज. सो इन द एग्जांपल ऑफ सेक्सुअल ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज इज एड्स. Hepatitis B, etc. So, create awareness. We have to create awareness among all the people about STD. STD means what? Sexually transmitted disease. And sexual, what do you mean by sexually transmitted disease? The disease that transmitted through sex is called as your sexually transmitted disease. As we know that, what are the example of sexually transmitted disease? एड्स एंड हेपाटाइटिस बी. एड्स विषय जानिथिबो जदि जणो को हबो कहले आउ तार पार्टनर को होची कि नै रे. सो थ्रू इच ऑर्गन, थ्रू द सेक्स ऑर्गन द डिजीज इज ट्रांसमिटेड. जो तमर एड्स होची कहा द्वारा होची रे, सेक्स ऑर्गन द्वारा ट्रांसमिटेड होची. दैट्स व्हाई एड्स अंडरगोस सेक्सुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज. क्लियर? देन सी, दिस शुड नो अबाउट द आर्ट्स. So what do we mean by arts? Arts means assisted reproductive ARTS. Arts means assisted reproductive technologies. That means there are many technologies in India that is helpful for the avoid of pregnancy. India re bahut kichi technology achi pile jodake ame later class we will discuss in later class, so that ame pregnancy kon kar pariya, avoid kar pariya. That is called as your arts. Again I repeated, arts means assisted reproductive technologies. Assisted reproductive technology means the technology that are used to avoid pregnancy. जदि जन प्रेग्नेंट हबनि से छुआ करि परबो किरे नाही, तो कोन हबो हमर बहुत गुडा टेक्नोलॉजी अछि दैट इज यूज्ड फॉर द अवॉइडिंग ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी. सो हमरो इंडिया रे बहुत, देयर आर मेनी टेक्नोलॉजीज इन इंडिया दैट इज यूज्ड टू अवॉइड प्रेगनेंसी. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज योर असिस्टेड रिप्रोडक्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी. देन द नेक्स्ट स्ट्रेटजी इज नहीं गला. सो इट्स ऑल अबाउट टुडेज क्लास. नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मेथड इन रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू मैम.